Yo, kid.
Y'all ready to get
hey! The most important part of dance is music.
Three, two, one, and I go! Ha! Ha! Ha!
Ha! Hey!
Uh-huh. The beats.
Combo and me, Cube, and Coin used to own the Bantam Street area in this city. It's a little far from Tokyo, but everyone used to stay out of our way there. Till recently, that is. Someone been going around painting these ugly signs all over Grind City. It's so ugly I can't even call it graffiti. Strange paintings of rhinos and bizarre symbols. All of our old graffiti has been covered up by these horrific signs. And on top of that, Coin has been kidnapped and his enormous collection of records has been destroyed. Ever since the emergence of these paintings, strange things been happening in this city too. Unfamiliar black cars and men in black suits are hanging around the streets as if they're waiting for something. And wait, was that statue here at Grind Square always this color? There's definitely something wrong here. I smell something fishy going on.
Yeah.
There was a message on a piece of graffiti. I think it was from Coin. He told me to go to Grind Square. It seems like the punks that been painting those ugly pieces of art have been hanging around Grind Square too. They probably already know that we've been painting over their stuff with our own symbols. They may be dangerous, but we can't let them take over. It's time to throw a little spray paint party and see if they come and try to crash it.
Hey! Ha!
Square. The whole place was built by the Rokkaku group. And I'm starting to get the feeling that those men in black suits are somehow connected to the Rokkaku. And this message that Coin left me, I don't understand it. What's this golden rhino that he painted? Does it have anything to do with the Rokkaku? Is all of this their doing? And is anything strange going on in Tokyo, too? What's this new radio station, Jet Set Radio, that everybody keeps talking about? Well, I'm sort of one-track-minded. And now that it looks like I'm involved in something big here, I got no choice but to fly to Tokyo. And if my contacts are right, the first guys I need to get a hold of are these people that call themselves the GGs.
Okay. Understand what's going on here.
Give me a break.
Die.
I said it before and I'll say it again.
Yeah.
Die. Again, 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 again.
Yeah.
Again, again, again.
We got another letter from Osaki. He says, I burned my house down. What should I do now? How should I know, fool? It turns out the Golden Rhinos are a secret branch of the Rokuku group. They're a dangerous bunch, cool and cruel. They got a martini in one hand and a switchblade in the other. Looks like they're wiping out everyone who tries to hang on the streets. Go on and hit them back. Make them feel you.
Sweet soul. Communication center to all Golden Rhinos. Assassin number 2 is heading your way in a high-speed aircraft. Wait for his arrival. Those kids are in the sewers. Go check it out.
Yeah.
And now, this report from our informant in Benton Cho, the Pink No Shijin. The thing everyone's been hunting for like crazy is something called the Devil's Contract. It's a record that's got the power to summon a demon. The streets of Tokyo-do are in a panic, and we're gonna have to cut off this broadcast soon. Can the Gigi's graffiti save this city?
Go!
understand what's going on here.
Yeah. Sweet.
expect fire damage.
Get scratching.
Jet Set Radio! The nasty Rucker Crew posters have all been covered up by GG Graffiti. Way to go! But when they weren't looking, someone swiped the record. You gotta go after them, right?
Give me a break.
Understand what's going on here.
Yeah.
That's right.
Jet Set Radio! That record everybody's looking for is already missing. According to some info we got from Poison Jam, it sounds like that record's the real thing. It was made by some freaky evil sound engineer, and it's been passed hand to hand all the way to Tokyo. Goji wants to use the record to make a contract with a demon so he can take over Tokyo and the rest of the world. If those guys get all the pieces, Tokyo, this radio station, sushi, ramen, hamburgers, and everything else are going to be history. Get to the new Rokuku headquarters and destroy that record, along with Goji's evil plans.
So. Ha!
that huge turntable of evil, the Rokkaku building is a pile of dust, right along with the Rokkaku ski. Now they're saying that the building was destroyed in a construction accident. Yeah, right. But now, Goji's son is taking over the Rokkaku family business, and Tokyo is back to its glorious old self. Turns out the Golden Rhinos were just another group of Goji's henchmen. That explains a lot. However, not all ended well. Coin had been pulled too deep into the schemes of the Rokkaku and paid a steep price. And all because Goji was obsessed with control. He didn't know how to deal with people that he couldn't buy with his money. Maybe he really is lonely at the top. Or maybe he's just another eccentric millionaire. Let us say that money is the root of all evil. Maybe it really can twist the hearts of men. It turns out the record that Goji was looking for, the Devil's Contract, was just an old indie record, a hoax. Maybe his twisted mind created the whole story out of rumors and superstitions in order to try and sate the demons of his own heart. Nevertheless, the noise tanks are in repair. The love shockers are all broken-hearted again, but Poison Jam is back and planning more mischief. In the end, it looks like they were the same as all of us after all. They'd been looking for something more, just trying to make sense of their own lives. Perhaps not. But how can anyone know the real truth behind it all?
Let's look at the fuck.
What's that? You think I just made all that up? Sure, okay. But watch out. Someone just might have their sights on Shibuya Cho again. On the street, there's no such thing as... Jet Set Radio!